Congressman Hodes, you supported the health care program as it is, but you also supported public option. Two parts. How would it help reduce costs without compromising care? And as a senator, will you be independent and propose the addition of a public option?
John, thanks. I did support the public option because I think it's critical that we give control of health care back to the people and take it away from the health insurance companies that have, frankly, abused many in the population. A public option would provide an alternative to the health insurance companies, and I think it's good. It's the right thing to do. I would support it, and I think we ought to have one. I think, as we're seeing now, what health insurance companies are doing is they're still raising rates, and I would have appreciated a public option as a counterbalance to help keep those rates down. So I think we need stronger reform, not weaker reform. But I'll tell you this. The real face of health care reform is not in the statistics or even the costs. It's in Gail O'Brien, who's sitting here tonight from Keene, who had to spend $20,000 of her own money getting cancer testing to see if she had the disease and then couldn't get insurance because she had a pre-existing condition. She's the first person in the United States to be able to take advantage of the pool that allows people with pre-existing conditions to get health insurance, and she's now getting cancer therapy, which will help save her life. That's the face of health care reform in New Hampshire. That's why I voted for it, not because it was a politically easy thing to do at a time when there was divided opinion, but it's because it's the right thing to do for the people in New Hampshire. It was the right thing to do for Gail O'Brien.
John, do you have a follow-up for Ms. Ayotte?
Well, I would just ask you to respond to that. He makes a case. He has Ms. O'Brien here. And what do you say to her?
Well, first I would say, Congressman Hodes, we certainly, when it comes to Mrs. O'Brien and others, we want to make sure that people have coverage in this country. But we don't need that from Washington. There can be state solutions to these issues. And Congressman Hodes supports this public option, which is the government, more and more government involvement in our health care, more and more where it comes between Washington becoming between us and our physicians. And let's talk about that health care bill, because unfortunately, health care costs were too expensive before they passed the bill, and yet the Senators for Medicare and Medicaid Services have said, this takes us in the wrong direction. It bends the cost curve upward, and we're already seeing agencies like the NFIB announcing that 1,500 businesses will see premium increases as a result of that bill here in New Hampshire. I've gone around and I've met with our medical device companies, many of them here in New Hampshire. I met with one in Portsmouth. They're going to have to give up a third of their research and development budget because of the taxes in that bill. And ultimately, it's the wrong approach to have Washington dictate to us in New Hampshire how we should handle health care. I firmly believe that we need private market reforms, more competition to lower costs, because this bill is going to increase our health care costs. And
Ms. Ayotte, we're going to stay on that topic, actually, with another question that comes from James Pindle, and as luck would have it, it's directed toward you.
Well, Ms. Ayotte, let's stick on this issue a bit. You've called for repealing this recent health care bill, yet recently Senator Gregg disagrees with that position. He says that we should reshape it or restructure it and not repeal it. Why is Senator Gregg wrong?
Well, again, I have great respect for Senator Gregg. But you know, it's interesting that Senator Gregg drafted an op-ed and he published it 3 days ago. And you know what he said in that op-ed? And I fully agree with him on it. He said that disguised as helpful, masked by promises of lower premiums and better coverage and cloaked by the secrecy of backroom dealing. Let's not forget all the Cornhusker kickback, the Louisiana purchase, the process by which this bill was enacted. He said, "This law has already begun to inflict great harm on the American people, on our economy, and on health care." So certainly we need to repeal this law. We need to replace it with common sense market reforms, tort reforms so our physicians don't have to practice defensive medicine. Let's allow portability of tax treatment so that if you get your health insurance from your employer, you also get that same tax benefit if you purchase it as an individual, so you can take it with you. There are reforms that we could enact that deal with health care costs and really that aren't dealt with in this bill. And Senator Gregg has already said there's great harm to America as a result of this bill, and I agree with him.
Congressman, 1 minute.
Under the health care reform bill, small businesses are already getting tax cuts to help their employees purchase health insurance. Seniors are getting money to help them pay for their prescription drugs. kids with pre-existing conditions up to the age of 19 now must be sold health insurance instead of being refused by their insurance companies. Kids up to the age of 26 can be on their parents' policies. And folks like Gail O'Brien have access to life-saving treatments because of the health care reform bill. Ms. Ayotte, as counsel to Governor Benson, as Attorney General, you had government-sponsored, taxpayer-subsidized health care. Why is it good enough for you but not good enough for Gail O'Brien? Why do you say it was okay for you to have taxpayer-subsidized, government-sponsored health care, but you want to take it away from Ms. O'Brien?
You know, Congressman Hodes, I happen to work for the state of New Hampshire, and I happen to deal with those health insurance companies that you like to criticize all the time when I was an employee of the state. But that's ridiculous. That's not the point here. The point is that the bill that you voted for is one that is going to cost our small businesses more money and put them with a difficult choice of, do I continue coverage of health care or do I have to pay fines? And we've already heard employers around the nation talking about that. This is the wrong direction. And you know what happened? Harvard Pilgrim already announced that it's going to drop 22,000 seniors from its Medicare Advantage plan here in New Hampshire, Maine, and Massachusetts because of this health care reform bill. It cut $500 billion from Medicare.
Move on.